Imagine a world before telescopes, when the universe was only what you could see with the naked eye. It was obvious that Earth was motionless, and that everything in the heavens, the sun, the moon, the stars, the planets, revolved around us. And then, a Polish astronomer and priest named Copernicus made a radical proposal. The Earth was not the center. It was just one of the planets, and like them, it revolved around the sun. Many, like the Protestant reformer Martin Luther, took this idea as a scandalous affront to Scripture. They were horrified. But for one man, Copernicus didn't go far enough. His name was Giordano Bruno, and he was a natural-born rebel. He longed to bust out of that cramped little universe. Even as a young Dominican monk in Naples, he was a misfit. This was a time when there was no freedom of thought in Italy. But Bruno hungered to know everything about God's creation. He dared to read the books banned by the church, and that was his undoing. In one of them, an ancient Roman, a man dead for more than 1,500 years, whispered to him of a universe far greater, one as boundless as his idea of God. Lucretius asked the reader to imagine standing at the edge of the universe and shooting an arrow outward. If the arrow keeps going, then clearly the universe extends beyond what you thought was the edge. But if the arrow doesn't keep going, say it hits a wall, then that wall must lie beyond what you thought was the edge of the universe. Now if you stand on that wall and shoot another arrow, there are only the same two possible outcomes. It either flies forever out into space, or it hits some boundary where you can stand and shoot yet another arrow. Either way, the universe is unbounded. Cosmos must be infinite. This made perfect sense to Bruno. The God he worshipped was infinite. So how, he reasoned, could creation be anything less? It was the last steady job he ever had. And then, when he was